Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's a bullet brawl. Don't you forget it. We have a Benko Gambit. This is a 1-0 bullet brawl. No increment today, so not for the faint of heart. Interesting. My opponent is having no shame about playing weirdness in bullet openings, but I'm going to be happy about that right now. Indeed I am. And we'll play some simple moves now. He's playing very, very fast, though. Wow, I'm way down on time already. Let's hope that it doesn't end up being the critical factor in this game, because we would like to win today's bullet brawl. We always want to win. Did you know that? When I play so badly, you're like, man, I understand why Danny loses all those bullet brawls now, because he doesn't always want to win. How weird. Right? He just sometimes wants to lose. It would make sense, actually, right? On a masochistic level. Okay, he's holding on right now. I had this threat of knight to d2, so I thought he would take it, but he didn't see it. So now that's more than enough material to win. Let's see if he wants another piece of this. AmirTiger 3000. Is that like AmirTiger? Like a mere threat or something. All right, well, this transpose into a weird Peirce. Maybe not the best for me. And when I say maybe, I mean it's definitely not the best. But he walks right into a position that we feel a lot better about than we did a few moves ago. Trying to... That's a good move. I'm going to say I'm going to try to take advantage of the weak e6 square. I would like to also get a piece on the e-file as long as there's this sort of awkward pin. But now he's going to play e5, isn't he? And he has no shame about it. Oh, okay, well, no b5 for you. My thought is maybe I can take advantage of the weak d6 pawn now that he's extended e5. Let's see if we can pull that off. Yeah, he's going to unpin the knight on f6, which is fine, but it doesn't mean that all of his problems are solved. With the d6 pawn still coming under fire, we are happy. Right? I'm not going to go for Roe Williams on this and confuse everybody with room without a roof, but I think we're happy. Let's make some simplification of the position. I know I missed bishop e7 earlier. I see it. I see that I missed it. I didn't want to trade because I wanted knight to d6 because I have threats of knight f7 check. He's going to take it. Okay, wow, I'm losing on time. This guy's very, very fast for some reason. Either that or I'm just playing particularly slow right now, which is totally possible. Let's really pick up the game here. Try to make some simplifications of the position. If he takes on e1, we'll take it. I'm just going to go take here. And then I'm going to defend. Because I want to make sure I don't lose on time. Okay, now I need to calm down because it doesn't look like I'm going to lose on time anymore. Right? Since it doesn't look like I'm going to lose on time anymore. Oh, wait, I'm still going to lose on time. Ugh. Well, I can only hope that I'll get a draw by 3-move repetition. Because I definitely blew it. The only problem is I can't play 50 moves. I can't play 50 moves before I lose on time. Wow, whatever. How ridiculous was that? It's my fault, though. Completely winning in this bullet brawl, and I just turned it into an actual brawl, right? It was just a dominance. It was pure dominance, and I lost that totally winning position. Really not playing my fastest right now, so I'm just going to try to pick it up a little bit. Not playing as fast as we are capable of right now. Come on, make a move, mouse. Make a move. Still not a great position for him, to say the least. That is not fun for him right now. We'd like to bring a rook into the second rank, and we're going to do just that. Wait a second, do I have bishop takes g2? I think I do. I think I do, Billy Blue. Pretty sure that's game over. Oh, wait a second. Wait, hold a tick. Did I just blow it in a weird way? I'm not just winning anymore on the light squares. Somehow, some way, I'm not just winning. Wow. Wow, that was frustrating. Wow. Well, I'm going to win this bullet brawl. That is the truth. The only problem is I'm not going to do it cleanly and just dominate this guy, given the positions I had. So, but I'm gonna play and I'm gonna win. Don't you worry about it. I probably shouldn't have traded queens, but. Trying to just do things that might make him lose on time right now. Given that I have no chance otherwise. Ugh, I actually almost did it. Well, now it's over. Now it is frustration time, and we're gonna bust out as many wins as the party asks for. It's a bononi. If you don't know the baloney, good for you. It means you spent your time focused on things that matter. Okay, well, I'll just play f6. Seems good enough for me. Alright, I could take on g7 and sack the queen, but why? Unnecessary would that be? Bring out the queen. Bring in the knight to g5. Now let's see, we'll just take on g6 and play f7. I wish there was something maybe more concrete. Maybe it was, but I just didn't see it. Ah, wait. I guess he's not going to take f7. I just assumed he would. Yeah, but that's check, buddy. That's checkarooski. I think you might have forgotten about that. He just offered me a draw. Really? Classy guy, given the kind of wins he's had too. Makes sense. Real classy. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, he's still playing. Still likes his chances, he does. Alright. Come on now, buddy. Shouldn't even be in this position, Amir. AmirTiger. We have transposed officially into what would be considered a Chichilian. A Chichilian indeed. An accelerated dragon Sicilian. Okay, I guess we'll just leave it the way it is until he wants to get castled. Given that the opposite code bishops are okay for us, with the dark squares being as delicious as they are. I wanted something else, but I didn't have it. Wanted something better, but it did not seem to exist. And again, he's playing very, very fast. Gotta give it to him, right? Gotta give him the speed that he's earned. For sure. I think that's mate, buddy. That's what happens when the dark squares go wild. Dark squares gone bad. Well, I'm not stopping this brawl until I lose. So you are all going to be in for something epic today. Something epic this way comes. No soup for you. Not in this Benoni, not in this lifetime. I'm still going to go for e5 as soon as I can get it. And I got it. Yeah, I'll go ahead and take that guy. Take that guy. Why not? We have a lot of pawns. A lot of pawns in the center. Okay, we'll just keep it closed. Keep it closed until we can win that f-pawn. Or maybe even start an attack with something like f5 here. Looks pretty good. Let's do it. This has got to be winning. Got to be winning. Oh, I almost took f7. But good enough this is. It's made on the dark squares. And the brawl continues, making up for my losses, putting my money where my mouth is. Frustration being something that brings out the focus in all of us. Doesn't matter what day it is. It's a Wednesday for right now because it's bullet brawl time. That's all that matters. Recently changed from Thursdays to Wednesdays. I always thought I could be that guy that does the little voice at the end of commercials and says, like, using this product is going to kill you. Something like that. May cause liver, heart disease, and, you know, whatever, just name it. I thought I could do that. I think I talk fast enough, and I think I, you know, have, you know, enough of a black soul, a dark soul, you know, to do something like that, where you just literally say things where people are going to die and, you know, you're okay with it. I think I could do that. I think I could be that guy. Really do. Let's take everything. Let's put the knight on f6, and let's try to get something going here. You know what I really want to do is undo my weakness before it's too late. That's what I really want to do. And what I wanted to do before that was get an attack going on the king side, but I didn't have enough. There was nothing there. I guess I'm going to free it. Free the back rank. Free Willy right now. And I'm still losing on time to this guy in every single game. Gotta give it to him. Frustrating it is. Aha, he stops us. Oh no. I should have stopped king to c4. That was stupid of me. With c4 check, it would have been so nice. It was stupid of me. Oh no, you're kidding me. I can't stop the pawn. Darn it. Man, oh man. Gingerbread man. How many times am I going to be an idiot? I don't know. As many times as it takes, son. It said in the voice of James Earl Jones watching over me. All right. Seriously, though, let's win chess games and not make excuses. That's what I want to do. I want to win chess games all day. All day, that's what I want to do. I just want to win chess games. I don't have any other dreams in my life. Okay, just a big discovery that does nothing. We'll back up. Let him take on e3 if he wants it. Not super worried about it. We'll take there. Develop the attack we will. Okay, we'll bring this guy in. There's another threat here with knight to f6 check. Okay, so he doesn't like that, so he's running. Okay, but now we have this check. And with it, a lot of other checks. Yeah. Yeah, that just happened. Okay, this Nimzo Indian has got to go down. I'm going to take this Nimzo down, you know what I mean? Aha, we like that. We like that a lot. Sure do. We are okay with what is taking place on the king side. Now I want to play c5 and close up, but then he kind of did it for me. We'll bring some pieces back to targeting the normal squares that need to be targeted in a Nimzo. Yeah, we'll attack. F3. Maybe we'll go threaten some move like knight f4. He sees it, doesn't want any piece of it, understandably so, but he didn't see that one. Too many tactics, not enough time. Oh, queen to c1 check was winning the rook. But he missed it a second time. Oh, wait, it wasn't winning the rook, that's why he missed it. Because it actually did nothing. Need to get the other rook over so I can play f5 and get more pieces into the attack. That's a knight. Another pawn. Let's open things up. Really? Okay. Well, I wish I could say he was stalemated, but he's not. I wish for his sake I could say that he was stalemated, but he's not. Well, you know what? We knew it would be epic, didn't we? The 100th Bullet Brawl. Guess what? We're going to play 100 bullet games on today's Bullet Brawl. That's what epic is. That's what epic does. No, if I did that, literally my excellent video producer, who I'm dedicating this 100th Bullet Brawl video to, Michael Pennywork. You can follow him on Twitter. There you go, Michael. Show your follow sign. Seriously, Michael does so much. He does everything for me. He does everything for me. Like, he listens to me when I've had a bad day. He entertains all of my horrible ideas. So what's special about the 100th Bullet Brawl? That it's dedicated to Michael Pennywork. I bet he didn't see that coming, did he? So that's what's special about today. It is the 100th Bullet Brawl. We have done 100 of these, and I am just going to crush him now. I want to crush it. I guess this is the best way to do it. I was just like, well, how can you do this? But Michael, seriously, is just the man. Does everything and then some for me. Recording, he records with all of our authors, so all the videos you see on the main site, that's right, those are Pennywork. All the videos you see on YouTube, those are Michael Pennywork. Multi-talented, follow him on Twitter. Say, hey man, I hear you're just so awesome. And you would be right to hear that. Okay, well, we'll go threaten Queen H6. And Queen to G7, mate. At the same time. So, what may also be special about this Bullet Brawl will be my ability to ride my opponent to 2,500 if we can do it. Or at least get this frustration to be put into something productive. But really, thank you Michael Pennywork for doing this. Thank you YouTube fans. We've made it to 100 Bullet Brawls. We should all be happy. We've all did it. We all did it. It was all of us. We came together at a time when the world needed heroes, and we gave them what the world needed. We gave them a hero to root for. I'll give them a hero. I'll give them a hero. I'll give them something they've never seen before. Something like that. I'm pretty sure that was said in some weird superhero movie at some point. Well, this has been a tricky one, right? Because I blew the opening somehow and got this weird position where I'm down a pawn. But White's position is also leaving something to be desired with these doubled C pawns, right? And his bishop is blocked. Okay, and now I'll take. And I'll shake and bake. And he can give check all he wants. I don't really care. Because I want to play knight takes check anyway. So that I can take on e1, and then play queen to g5, and then what? I guess play rook to g1, thinking that probably there's going to be a mate. I don't want to get my king in trouble, so I'll just create a little bit of a luft for that guy. You know that guy, that king, right? Always getting into trouble, that guy, that pesky king. All right, well, I haven't seen a way to win immediately, which has been weird. But we finally did it. And we're not stopping there. We're climbing right now. It's a special day. It's a special day for you. A special day for me. Most importantly, it's a special day for Michael. Michael Pennywork, this one is for you. That might be where we end it. He just said he doesn't want to play anymore. You gotta be kidding me, dude. Do you know that you're... This is the epic Bullet Brawl, the 100th Bullet Brawl, and you're calling it on a technicality, right? What's you doing here? No, that's actually, it wasn't a technicality. What mattered was I lost more games than I probably should have, but I'm going to take it. We pushed our way back toward 2,500. We dedicated the 100th Bullet Brawl to Michael Pennywork, and we did it. We did it all together. Good day to you, sir. Good day.